Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whenever you happen to be watching this. Welcome along to another match day experience on the channel, and it's non-league day. Get in, a day up and down the country that everyone gets behind. It's international weekend, which means that you guys, who may or may not normally watch non-league football, can go out and sample what non-league has to offer. So my question to you guys is, what game did you go and watch this weekend? So let me know down in the comment section what game you visited. But today, it's SIO action, it's first versus second as Cranes head to Old Newton. If we have a look at the league table here, neither team have lost a game of football this season. Old Newton have drawn once, and that's what separates the two teams. Macca has said during the week that it's going to be a very, very good test to see where his Old Newton team are. And it's an opportunity I couldn't turn down. Cranes normally have somebody there along with their matches who records all of the games. But he approached me on Monday night and said to me, look, I'm not going to be at this game. Do you want to come along and watch it? It's Cranes are a team that are always up there, but I never really managed to go and watch them because of that reason. So I'm really excited to see what they're all about. But yeah, got about an hour or so to go before kickoff. Let's head to Old Newton. Well, what a glorious day, eh? Horrible weather. Shouldn't put a lot of people off though, to be honest. If you've got an umbrella like I have, you should be absolutely fine. It's this is the kind of weather that if you're playing in, this is perfect. This is perfect conditions for playing in. These are the kind of matches that I would actually enjoy. I'm not a big fan of playing in the heat, but this kind of weather, this is exactly it. But yeah, I've just spoken to kind of both teams, had a little bit of a chat with both sets of coaching staff, etc. Both looking forward to this game. There's a couple of injuries for Old Newton beforehand, which should make for an interesting game. But if I just show you there, I don't know if you can see it, but currently work is being done on the dugouts here at Old Newton. But because of the bad weather yesterday, that had to be kind of put off. They would have hoped that one of them would have been done on time. But small progress being made at the club. But yeah, let's do this. Oh, I'm excited. Let's go. To be honest, absolutely no less than they've deserved. They have been, honestly, that's probably been the best performance so far
from a team I've seen this season. They've just absolutely dominated it. They're first to everything. They win every single ball. They're quicker, they're faster, they're stronger. They've been absolutely brilliant, Cranes. I'm really, really am impressed by them. They just haven't allowed Old Newton to get going at all. Every time Old Newton get the ball, they're forced to play it long because they're just forcing them into mistakes. And yeah, good goal from a corner place, but as I said, fully, fully deserved. Half time, 1-0 to Cranes. Can't really sum up better than how I summed up the first goal, to be honest. They've just been quicker, they've been stronger to everything, far more movement and creativity. They haven't allowed Old Newton any time to get on the ball and sort of build up anything. So Old Newton are basically just resorting to kicking the ball long. And that's not a reflection on Old Newton. That is how well Cranes have done in that first half. I think the disappointing thing for Cranes is the fact that they should be more than 1-0 up. From an Old Newton perspective, haven't been able to get going, haven't had a chances to get going, and a positive for them is the fact that it is only 1-0. That is really how probably best to sum up that half of football, but it's pouring it down with rain. Yeah, lovely stuff. I'll see you in the second half. So 5 minutes into the second half, it's just a free kick. It's gone right through everyone. Keeper's kind of gone one way, thinking that one of the players is going to get a flick onto it. He doesn't. Go straight to the bottom corner. 2-0 Cranes. A very clever disguised ball into the box, and it's a very, very calm and very composed finish. We've got a game on 2-1. So I reckon I've got about 10 minutes to go. That goal has really kind of shook Cranes up, to be honest. They've been doing really well in this game, but the moment that goal's gone in, all of a sudden the passes are going a bit astray. The intensity is just not quite there, and I've been hearing a load of Cranes players saying we just need to calm it down and just slow the game down because it's just gone a million miles an hour. Old Newton have just been, they've upped their game massively in this second half. We've got about 10 minutes to go, been a surprise kind of turn of events for me anyway. Maka, manager for Old Newton, is on the pitch as a sub. Can he get a goal? Wouldn't that be a story? Go! So full time 2-1 to Cranes in the end. Not really an awful lot kind of happened in that last sort of 10 minutes or so. There was a lot of kind of long balls trying to create something from an Old Newsman perspective, but Cranes in those final 10 minutes, they did calm down, they did slow the game down, they were going into the corners a lot, breaking up play, and they were causing, you know, they just completely did what they had to do in to really sort of run the result out. And very impressive in the first half. Second half, not so much, but you know, that's to kind of be expected. I think the moment they went 2-0 up, I don't know if they put their foot off the gas, but I think Old Newton just was like, well, we've got nothing to lose now, we're 2-0 down, we're just going to go for it and really try and make a game of it. Got themselves the goal, and then it was all Old Newton. They had quite a few opportunities to put balls into the box, etc. Had a few kind of half chances, but didn't really create an awful lot. But as I said, Cranes just kind of managed that final 10-15 minutes, so that there wasn't an awful lot kind of going on really in that last bit. But another match day experience in the books, and this is what non-league is about. I absolutely love it. You know, people say to me, James, why do you like non-league football? Well, to be honest, I like the rain and I like football, and I thought, why not combine the two? And here we are, Wally with the Brolly for today's game. But if you've enjoyed it, make sure you hit the like button, leave a comment and subscribe as always. Until next time, as always on the channel, adios.